My brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome you virtually as we gather this morning to praise and worship our one true God on this, the day of Pentecost. On Pentecost, God sent his Holy Spirit to be our helper and comforter. The Spirit awakens us to the love that God has for us, and in so doing, helps us to love others. I extend a special welcome to those who may be new to our parish and joining us online for this morning's service. For those I've not yet had the chance to meet, my name is Father Guy. I will preside and preach this morning. Our order of service is taken from the Book of Common Prayer, beginning at page 355 after the introductory sentence. As the Father has sent me, so I send you. When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit." Alleluia! Christ is risen. The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia! Let us pray together. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us proclaim together, glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, Heavenly King, Almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God the Father. Amen. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. O God, who on this day taught the hearts of your faithful people by sending to them the light of your Holy Spirit, grant us, by the same Spirit, to have a more right judgment in all things and evermore to rejoice in his holy comfort. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We will now have the ministry of the Word. First lesson is taken from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 2, beginning at verse 1. When the day of Pentecost had come, the disciples were all together in one place, and suddenly, from heaven, There came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared amongst them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit and began to speak in other languages as the Spirit gave them ability. Now there were devout Jews from every nation under heaven living in Jerusalem. And at this sound, the crowd gathered and were bewildered, because each one of them heard them speaking in the native language of each. Amazed and astonished, they asked, "Are all of these speaking not Galileans? And how is it that we hear each of us in our own native language? Parthians, Medes, Elamites, and residents of Mesopotamia, Judea, and Cappadocia, Pontus and Asia, Phrygia and Pamphylia, Egypt, and the parts of Libya belonging to Cyrene, and visitors from Rome, both Jews and proselytes, Cretans and Arabs, in our own languages, we hear them speaking about God's deeds of power." All were amazed and perplexed, saying to one another, "What does this mean?" But others sneered and said, "They are filled with the new wine." But Peter, standing with the 11, raised his voice and addressed them, "Men of Judea, and all who live in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and listen to what I say. Indeed, these are not drunk as you suppose, for it is only 9 o'clock in the morning. No, this is what was spoken through the prophet Joel. In the last days, it will be, God declares, that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and daughters shall prophesy, and your young men shall see visions, and your old men shall dream dreams. Even upon my slaves, both men and women, in those days I will pour out my spirit, and they shall prophesy. And I will show portents in the heaven above and signs on the earth below, blood and fire and smoky mist. The sun shall be turned to darkness and the moon to blood before the coming of the Lord's great and glorious day. Then everyone who calls on the name of the Lord shall be saved." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The psalm appointed for today, Psalm 104, beginning at the 25th verse. O Lord, how manifold are your works! In wisdom you have made them all. The earth is full of your creatures. Yonder is the great and wide sea, with its living things too many to number, creatures both small and great. There move the ships, and there is that Leviathan, which you have made for the sport of it. All of them look to you, and give them their food in due season. You give it to them, they gather it, and you open your hand, and they are filled with good things. You hide your face, and they are terrified. You take away their breath, and they die and return to the dust. You send forth your spirit, and they are created, and so you renew the face of the earth. May the glory of the Lord endure forever. May the Lord rejoice in all his good works. He looks at the earth and it trembles. He touches the mountains and they smoke. I will sing to the Lord as long as I live. I will praise my God while I have my being. May these words of mine please him. I will rejoice in the Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Hallelujah. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. Our epistle is taken from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 12, beginning at the third verse. No one can say, Jesus is Lord, except by the Holy Spirit. Now there are varieties of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are varieties of services, but the same Lord. And there are varieties of activities, but it is the same God who activates all of them in everyone. To each is given the manifestation of the Spirit for the common good. To one is given through the Spirit the utterance of wisdom. To another, the utterance of knowledge according to the same Spirit. To another, faith by the same Spirit. To another, gifts of healing by the one Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, discernment of spirits. And another, various kinds of tongues. To another, the interpretation of tongues. All these are activated by one and the same Spirit, who allots to each one individually, just as the Spirit chooses. For just as the body is one and has many members, and all the members of the body, though many, are one body, so it is with Christ. For in the one Spirit we were all baptized into one body, Jews or Greeks, slaves or free, and we were all made to drink of the one Spirit. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. As we now prepare to receive the Holy Gospel of our Lord, we will have as our gradual the hymn, Spirit of Mercy, Truth and Love.
Thank you.
The gospel acclamation is this: Alleluia, Alleluia. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and kindle in them the fire of your love. Alleluia. The Lord be with you. The continuation of the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to John. Glory to you, O Christ. When it was evening of the day of the resurrection, the first day of the week, and the doors of the house where the disciples had met were locked for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood amongst them and said, "Peace be with you." After he said this, he showed them his hands and his side. Then the disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven. But if you retain the sins of any, they are retained." My brothers and sisters in Christ, this is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Christ. We heard in today's first reading from the Acts of the Apostles, when the day of Pentecost had come, the disciples were all gathered together in one place, and suddenly from heaven there came a sound like the rush of a violent wind, and it filled the entire house where they were sitting. Divided tongues as of fire appeared amongst them, and a tongue rested on each of them. All of them were filled with the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of our hearts be acceptable to you, O Lord, our Creator, our Redeemer and Sustainer. Amen. On this, the day of Pentecost, God sent his Holy Spirit to be our helper and comforter. The Spirit enabled, we heard, the apostles to proclaim the good news to all nations, and similarly calls us to action. At Pentecost, we remember that God, through the Holy Spirit, dwells in each of us. What a privilege that is. In Pentecost, the Spirit awakens us to the love that God has for us, and in so doing, helps us to love one another. Today I want to speak about my personal experience with the Holy Spirit. Without him, I would not be here with you. And just in case you were wondering, the Spirit did not come to me as a tongue of fire. And I guess in part that that's impractical with today's fire regulations. But nonetheless, he very did come. As many of y'all know, up to 2 years ago, I had a successful public sector career. 2 years ago, I left the glitz and glamour of being an ambassador in the UK, being among monarchs and princes and presidents and world leaders, all because of the Holy Spirit. And I want to share with you how that happened. But before I get into that, I want to give you some context. And I'll do that in the form of an analogy. As Barbados' ambassador in London, it was like being the Puerto Rican non-voting representative in the House. While I was there, a terrible scandal broke. People from Barbados were being denied their rights in the UK. Think of Puerto Ricans in the US being denied the right to work, being denied access to health care, being denied their pensions. Some were being detained and some were in fact deported. And during all of this, there was no action coming from Barbados, in part because the government didn't understand what was going on, but also because the government was wary of offending the powerful UK government. In the meantime, people were suffering, and it was in this turmoil that the Holy Spirit spoke to me. Most appropriately, the Holy Spirit spoke to me at Westminster Abbey. Ironically, it was during the service for the 50th anniversary of the assassination of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. During the service and in the sermon, the bishop recalled Dr. King's remarks that injustice anywhere is a threat to justice everywhere. And he gave an exhortation on the duty of everyone to work towards peace and justice on earth. And he urged the congregation there gathered to consider what could be done to address issues of injustice in their community. In that sermon, the Holy Spirit spoke, and I heard, and I prayed, and most importantly, I acted. I left that service and immediately began what was a successful campaign for the rights of Barbadians and other Caribbean citizens in the UK. This was unprecedented for a diplomat, but we got some of that justice that the people deserved. I believe that my actions were successful largely because it was God's will, and most importantly, that it was the Holy Spirit leading me. It was from that event that I heard God's call to end my career and devote my time and my talents to serving him and his people. And to quote the original Martin Luther, "Here I stand, I can do no other. God help me." Perhaps you have had similar experiences, or perhaps you may not have. And if you haven't, it doesn't mean that the Holy Spirit has passed you by. The Spirit continually reaches out to us through scripture and through hymns and in the liturgy, and very often in our prayer life when we are still. We are told in Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1, faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. And while it is unlikely that the Holy Spirit will function and communicate in the traditional form, whether it be a voice from heaven or a burning bush or tongues of fire or even a donkey, as happened to Balaam, God talks to us incessantly. What you may consider to be your heart or your conscience or your inner voice often is the Holy Spirit trying to get your attention. As we are assured in today's epistle, to each is given the manifestation of the Holy Spirit for the common good. But the challenge today, the challenge in our modern world, is that the Holy Spirit is often unable to enter our lives because too many of us want God in our lives on our terms, not His. The truth is that God often asks us to do something that we feel unable or not ready to do. As I told you all last week about the young man pushed in the pool with the alligators, often the Holy Spirit pushes us to move in directions that we are not ready for. Very often, the Holy Spirit seeks to push us out of our comfort zone in order that we go forward and grow in our faith, that we grow in our love, and that we grow in our hope. But too often, Christians prefer the Holy Spirit to be taken or to come in small, manageable doses. But God does not conform to our will, but we to His. In Romans chapter 12, verse 2, we are told this: do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good and acceptable and perfect. God wants to be in our lives. He wants to be with us through the good times and also the bad. But He can't do it. He can't do it if we are constantly trying to limit His presence and the love of God that has been generously poured out through the Holy Spirit. We heard in the first lesson today, in Acts chapter 2, that God declares, I will pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. Pour out, not measured out in teaspoonfuls, poured out upon all flesh. Many of us, many of you will have areas in your life that seem out of control, that many things that you are struggling with. This is an opportunity to let the Holy Spirit in and let God help you. Whether it is with an emotional upset, a physical challenge, a financial need, or a relationship problem, the solution to them all is the same. Let God in. Let the Spirit help. But letting God in is simple, but it isn't easy. And why I say it's simple? Because we are told in Psalm 46 verse 10, be still and know that I am God. Be still. But that's not easy. In our overcrowded, overflowing, overwhelming lives, being still is not easy, but it is necessary if we are going to encounter the Holy Spirit in a meaningful way. We are told in Exodus chapter 14, verse 14, the Lord will fight for you, and you only have to keep still. You only have to keep still. Whether with relationships, finances, career, health, when I look back on my life, the times that I have felt I had no control are the times I realized when God was most present. Some of the best times happened to me because I let God intervene. I trusted in Him, I had hope, and I felt His love. By faith, in hope, with love. And so, when we feel chaos and uncertainty in our lives, like what we went through recently, during this coronavirus pandemic, that has not ended yet by any stretch of the imagination. This is an opportunity for us to be strong in faith rather than resort to being anxious and panicking. And if you learn to trust God, you will spend much less time worrying about what could go wrong and so much more time being assured about the fidelity and the goodness of God. In Proverbs chapter 19, verse 21, we are told, people may devise many plans, but it is the purpose of the Lord that will prevail. I have learned, as I was taught in Philippians chapter 4, verse 13, I can do all things through Him who sustains me. I can do all things through Him who strengthens me. When we surrender control, when we wait and trust in the Lord's plan, we know that He will be faithful and lead us where He wants us to go. As we are told in Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 13, when you search for me, you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. If you search for me, you will find me if you seek me with all your heart. Seek God and He will direct your steps. But if it feels like you aren't connected to the Holy Spirit, don't be hard on yourself. Trusting in God is a lifelong process. Like many aspects of our faith, it is a choice that we have to work on and affirm every day. It is a journey where we have to learn to let go of trying to figure out the whys of life and understand and believe and trust that God understands and gets it more than we ever could. Ultimately, our faith is a process of living by the hymn by Judson Van Deventer. I surrender all. And the verse goes like this. All to Jesus, I surrender. All to Him, I freely give. I will ever love and trust Him. In His presence, daily live. The refrain, I surrender all. I surrender all. All to Thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. As we heard in our reading today, as the Father has sent me, so I send you. And when He had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. My brothers and sisters in Christ, I invite you to join me and let us surrender ourselves to God and his Holy Spirit through prayer. Let us pray. Almighty God, on this day you opened the way of eternal life by the promised gift of your Holy Spirit. Shed this gift throughout the world by the proclamation of your gospel, that it may reach to the ends of the earth and penetrate all hearts, minds, and souls. This we ask through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. 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 And now, because and knowing of God's presence, his continued existence and indwelling in us through his Holy Spirit, we profess our faith in that triune God in the words of the Nicene Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, the maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now, as we prepare to offer up the prayers of the people, let us focus our minds, our hearts, and our souls on God's gift of the Holy Spirit to be our helper, comforter, and guide. Let us pray. With all our heart and with all our mind, let us pray to the Lord using form I of the prayers of the people, saying, Lord, have mercy. For the peace of the world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God, and for the unity of all peoples, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Michael, our presiding bishop, Peter, our bishop, Bernie, our rural dean, for myself and Mario, our priest, and for all clergy and people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For Donald, our president, Ron, our governor, Josh, our mayor, and for the leaders of all nations, for all in authority, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the county of Broward, this city of Hollywood, for every city and community and for all those who live in them. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the good earth which God has given us, and for the wisdom and the will to conserve it, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the aged and the infirm, for the widows and orphans, for the sick and the suffering, especially those listed on our parish prayer list. Mary Rodriguez, Abby Watts, Stan Allen Jr., Nicholas Saunders, Heather Reed, Jennifer Garms, Riley Rupert Richendoller, Rodney Paisley, Cecilia Griffith, Angelica Williams, Cecile Patricia James, Zachary Williams, Isaiah Williams, Margaret Riesig, Nicole Goodwin, Pat Miller, Rinalda Schiffer, Cedric Straker, Stephanie and Jackson Howard Gomez, Theodora Jura Khan, Yvette Baker, and James Lowe. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For those celebrating birthdays, and we pray especially for Larry Williams and Octaviano Manrique, and for those celebrating anniversaries or anyone or anything which you care to include. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For the poor and the oppressed, for the unemployed and the destitute, for prisoners and captives, and for all who remember and care for them. And we continue to pray for continued protection for all those dealing on the front line with the COVID-19 pandemic. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For all who have died in the hope of the resurrection, and for all the departed, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. For deliverance from all danger, violence, oppression, and degradation, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy, that we may end our lives in faith and hope, without suffering and without reproach. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, have mercy. In communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. James, and of all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life to Christ our Lord. To thee, O Lord, our God. Hasten, O Father, the coming of thy kingdom, and grant that we, thy servants, who now live by faith, may with joy behold thy Son at his coming in glorious majesty, even Jesus Christ, our only mediator and advocate. Amen. Now, through the act of penitence, let us confess our sins against God and our neighbor. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry and humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. forgive you all your sins to our Lord Jesus Christ, strengthen you through the Holy Spirit in all goodness, and by the power of that same Spirit, keep you in eternal life. Amen. The peace of the Lord be always with you. Let us share God's peace. My brothers and sisters, before we go into the offertory and Holy Communion, I want to go through a few notices. As you may have read on Constant Contacts, the bishop, after consultation and careful consideration, has extended the closure of our parish and all churches in the diocese until at least the end of June. As a consequence, we will not be gathering for worship in person until July. In this period of extended liturgical distancing, I ask you to continue to reach out to one another so that people may feel, notwithstanding that apartness, that they are united in spirit and that we are indeed members of a living and vibrant church. I want to say also thank you to all those who have been giving faithfully to our parish, whether through mailing in checks, dropping off offerings in the secure mailbox, or using our online payment system. It is all much appreciated. As I shared before, after 20 years of operation, the daycare center at the back of the church is relocating. The vestry is working on a plan to ensure that the parish remains financially viable. But to do this, we are going to need your support. We are going to need your faithfulness to this parish. We are going to need your prayers for any new projects that come on stream. And we are going to need you to consider carefully if there is more that you can do to assist us as we go forward. I will be reaching out to each and every one of you in correspondence to explore what can possibly be done and how can you help us in going forward in our new ventures. I also want to continue to extend an invitation, whether through Zoom or on Facebook, to join us on Wednesdays at noon for our midweek service. It is an opportunity for us to come together in worship and to remain united as a parish family. And lastly, but by no means least, I want to remind you that tomorrow we officially enter the 2020 hurricane season. I ask you to make the necessary preparations and, like with COVID-19, continue to stay safe. And now, let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and our labor to the Lord. We will be led into our communion with the hymn, Holy, Holy, Holy.
Holy, 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 holy.
Our service continues with Eucharistic Prayer A on page 361. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them up to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give him thanks and praise. It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere, to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, through Jesus Christ our Lord. In fulfillment of his true promise, the Holy Spirit came down on this day from heaven, lighting upon the disciples to teach them and lead them into all truth, uniting peoples of many tongues in the confession of one faith, and giving to your church the power to serve you as a royal priesthood and to preach the gospel to all nations. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy and gracious Father, in your infinite love, you made us for yourself. And when we had fallen into sin and become subject to evil and death, you in your mercy sent Jesus Christ, your only and eternal Son, to share our human nature, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night that he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." And after supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink this, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be for your people the body and blood of your Son, the food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And all at the last day, bring us with the Blessed Virgin, St. James, and all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior has taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia! Christ, our Passover, is sacrificed for us. Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us thy peace. My brothers and sisters in Christ, the gifts of God for the people of God, take them in remembrance that Christ died for you and feed on him in your hearts by faith with thanksgiving. Lord, I'm not worthy. Lord, I'm not worthy. Worthy but to only say the word and I shall be healed. Body of love, body of grace. Let us now give thanks for this foretaste of the heavenly banquet and the spiritual food that we have received by praying together the post-communion prayer on page 365. Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ. And you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please bow your heads to receive God's blessing. The Spirit of truth lead you into all truth. Give you grace to confess that Jesus Christ is Lord and to proclaim the word and works of God, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you and those you love this day and forevermore. Amen. My brothers and sisters in Christ, our service has ended, so let us go forth into the world rejoicing in the power of the Spirit. Alleluia, alleluia. Thanks be to God. Alleluia, alleluia.